sold to capacity. 9,000 plus here at Cameron Indoor Stadium. Many legends, Gene Banks, who was part of a Final Four team in 78 with the G-Man, Jim Sponarkle, Kenny Denard, and Antoine Jameson, part of one of the great North Carolina teams that really lit up Duke during his tenure, as you'll be seeing and hearing more from Antoine at halftime. Names, now faces, trying to get places tonight at Cameron Indoor Stadium, the 239th meeting between these two, Roger Ayers, Pat Driscoll, Tim Nestor, our officials. And here's the opening tip. We're underway. Run down by Page of North Carolina.
Duke opens in the man-to-man.
Jackson, the freshman sensation, with a teardrop that does not fall, and it's pulled down by Emil Jefferson.
North Carolina, of course, very good on the offensive board, so it's going to be critical for Duke to block out, and they did on that first occasion.
Ball was kicked, but it'll be out of bounds to the Blue Devils. Only 8 seconds off the shot clock. Tyus Jones has really gotten warm, as has fellow freshman Justice Winslow since the release of Rashid Suleiman. Jefferson using the window, and it's 2-0 Duke. Tokita, who struggled up late, forces the issue there. Jefferson clears to Jones. Quick outlet to Cook from the corner. Count it. Cook has now hit a three-pointer in 36 straight games, one shy of tying Trajan Langdon for the Duke record. Blue Devils out to a hot start. Winslow end-to-end to Jones, and the dump down to Okafor. That one goes crying off the rim. Meeks with a clear out. Tokito decides to wait on help. Gets some from Johnson and he lays it through.
I think that's exactly what North Carolina needs to do. That was a great outlet pass by Kennedy Meeks. When you can make an outlet pass of that distance, you can get out and go. And that's, I think, what North Carolina has to do.
Beautiful fall away. We said earlier, Winslow's really warmed up along with Tyus Jones. Here on the other end, Jackson can't connect. And it's pulled down by Winslow again.
You want to play quickly, but you don't want to hurry, and that's what North Carolina has done for the most part early in the game, in too big a hurry.
Winslow, foul prior to the shot. Driscoll saw it. Let's get our Carolina forward keys to the game, Dan.
I think for North Carolina, it's toughness in transition. They've got to be much tougher than they were, particularly on the defensive end, than they were against Pittsburgh. And we've said they've got to get out in transition. And Duke has some advantages. If they have some advantages, if you're able to attack the basket and they have that big advantage in Okafor inside, they've got to attack.
Winslow attacks. And the Devils out to a 9-2 lead. He's got four. That foul, by the way, was on Marcus Page. Here's Johnson. He's fouled as he takes it to the rack in the act.
And we talked before the game about Winslow being a very difficult matchup. You saw him take and shoot the jump shot. Now, okay, he's established that. He's going to drive to the basket. He's an excellent three-point shooter. I think North Carolina is going to have their hands full with him tonight.
Obviously, against the Devils a year ago, he was outstanding. 7 of 9 from the floor with 9 boards. And he has really emerged in recent weeks for Roy Williams' club. I mean, minus the Pitt game, which was one of those days. Mike Jaminski and I were there for that game on Saturday. Pittsburgh shot a torrid percentage, really out of character. And North Carolina, who had played really well defensively all season long, had their fair share of breakdowns as well. That was addressed in practice this week by Roy Williams. Duke is 4 out of 5 from the floor, and they're taking really good shots. Cook, that's his spot. Off the back iron this time, and it's tapped out of there by Jackson to Marcus Page. Kennedy Meeks rejected by Okafor.
That's a good defensive play by Okafor, but if you're North Carolina, I think you've got to attack him.
Jahlil does, right into the chest of Meeks for his first bucket.
He does such a great job creating space for himself inside.
Okoto off the front iron. Okafor clears. Blue Devils look really to be in sync. Beautiful dump down. Jefferson reversal.
Tim, you're absolutely right. Duke is doing whatever they want to do at this point. North Carolina not really putting up much resistance.
Start giving up too many layups, and North Carolina did in that game with Pitt. It can become a real problem.
The other problem is they're only 1-for-7.
And they've settled on some quick shots. Here's Meeks, baseline extended, gets that one to go to stop the bleeding for the folks from Blue Heaven. 13-6.
Meeks is much better at that little short jump shot, and I think if he can make that and draw Okafor away from the basket, that'll help North Carolina.
Oh, the alley-oop, and off the glass too. Freshman to freshman. Page on a blow by, offensive foul. Player control, and right now Duke has control. Page gets his second. Oop time at Cameron. This was the scene just moments before the starting lineups were announced. Both the teams arm in arm with a moment of silence, honoring the memory of the great Dean Smith. I think even the closest Tar Heel fans to Roy Williams would tell you that Mike Krzyzewski's statements in the aftermath of his passing were some of the most poignant made. Certainly he is walking in similar shoes to that of Dean Smith. A lot of care and concern for both of these programs, each made better because of the existence of both.
Man, it's a situation I think that really dealt a tough blow to Roy Williams. You always think you're ready for that kind of thing because Coach Smith had been sick for a couple of years, but Roy Williams, I think, very, very affected by it, obviously.
No question. Matt Jones is into the game. Missed that one, number 13 in white, the sophomore.
North Carolina's got to dig in here on the defensive end, Tim. We talked about toughness being one of the keys, and this isn't very tough. Right?
No, I mean, they're getting layups here.
That's like the layup line.
17-6, the Blue Devils.
Nothing complicated there, just a screen. Nobody helped out, and he was able to go right to the basket.
Here's Hicks on an alley-oop. Return to sender from the Tar Heels. As Isaiah gets back into the game, he had started a couple of times, did not tonight. In the aftermath of that game, Joel James has also come into the game for North Carolina, number 42 in blue. And Joel Berry, the freshman who's coming out of that groin injury, played very effectively at Pitt with 8.6 assists. No turnovers in that game. And this time trying to get through the ball screen, he picks up a foul.
And North Carolina, they have struggled on both ends of the court, and this is where you get well on the offensive end of the court. An excellent pass, and Hicks with a great cut.
Berry with his first. Three team fouls, the other two belong to Page. Cook. He has six, and the lead is a dozen.
North Carolina in danger of getting just absolutely blown out here early in the game.
Berry off the bounce, gets it to go. I don't see the intensity, Dan, that we expected we'd see on the defensive end from North Carolina.
Tim, I think a lot of that has to do with the way you play on offense. The ball's not going in the basket, you get discouraged. That's what happened to North Carolina up in Pittsburgh, and they've got to be thinking, oh no, not again.
Cook. Got it deflected. Now that was a good sequence for North Carolina. They've made their last three field goals now, the Tar Heels. And here is a beautiful pass threaded in from Tokoto. And Nate Britt gets the layup, and it's a 20-12 game. So four quickly unanswered from North Carolina.
Cook has had an outstanding season. Career highs across the board. Has really been a catalyst for this Duke team. Everybody talks about the freshman, but Cook has just been outstanding.
Okafor back to Cook.
See, I'm not sure that you can double-team Okafor by bringing a guy off one of those three-point shooters. I think you've just got to rely on Joel James to keep his body between Okafor and the basket. Force Okafor to shoot over top of the defense.
James in traffic, puts it up with his left hand and answers with a deuce, 23-14.
And you have to attack him on the other end. I think the way Duke played against Rakeem Christmas in the Syracuse game, Christmas was very frustrated. He shot the ball very close to the basket, but he had to shoot it over somebody every time, and he had a tough time scoring.
And that's a walk by Okafor. Krzyzewski a little concerned that maybe there was a little too much body on him that time.
Well, there's going to be a lot of body on him. That's the way they play the game. But here you drop a guy off a three-point shooter. No, no. And Okafor, he's just as excited as if he made that basket himself.
James, boy, that beautiful little left-hand jump hook. 6 out of 6 now after a 1-for-7 start for the Heels. They're managing to stay in the game offensively, but it's down here on this end of the floor that's been a problem. The inside-out game, double, leaving someone open. Running this offense through Okafor, who can put it on the deck too, just like that.
Wow.
That's pretty good, isn't it?
Well, if you're going to double-team the guy, you can't let him dribble out of the double-team. Good heavens. Your point guard might be able to do that, but you can't let the other guy's center get away with that.
Hicks took steps. Okafor with outstanding defense.
And Tim Quinn Cook has been a key factor in the game with his ability to knock down the jump shot. I mean, you cannot leave him alone. And he's done an excellent job. He's found open people, and then the ball goes inside, comes back outside. Cook has been outstanding. There it goes again.
From the corner again.
You know, eventually they're going to have to guard him.
Everything's passive in their man coverage, North Carolina. They've got to close out on those shooters, and they're just not doing it. There's a foul as, again, on a drive to the bucket. Blue Devils commit the foul. Jefferson hit the deck. Winslow did, too. Foul goes against Winslow.
Winslow never got in position, and even had he been in position, he was in that restricted area. North Carolina has to continue to attack. If they're not going to be able to get it done on the defensive end, they have to score, obviously, on this end to stay in the game.
Played very well in that Syracuse game. They carved apart the zone that night. Here comes a youngster, Grayson Allen, the freshman from Jacksonville, who's been getting more minutes since Suleiman was released from the program. First time in 40 years of coaching that had happened to Mike Krzyzewski. And frankly, as you look at some of the other changes being made, Bryce Johnson gets back out there for North Carolina along with Kennedy Meeks. At least statistically, you'd have to say, Dan, the loss of Suleiman has been addition by subtraction offensively for Duke. They have played and shot the ball a great deal better with the rotation limited really to 8 scholarship players.
Of course, you lack depth, but sometimes it's much better to have fewer guys. Everybody understands what's expected of them. It's a little bit more clear.
Allen off the alley-oop. Johnson defended it beautifully. Running the alley-oop, Jones tried to hit him. Britt gets a double, leaves it for Johnson from the top of the key, and he rattles it home.
And Tim, you pointed it out. Marcus Page picked up that second foul early.
That was big.
And North Carolina, they're trying to play without him and doing pretty good job so far.
You'd have to say offensively, he needed to have a big night. There's Grayson again. Oh, beautiful move, everything but the finish for Allen. You can see he's a gifted player, but struggled to get minutes early. On the overplay, Okafor. Is there anything he doesn't do? Oh, that's right. He does get stripped.
Well, maybe he shouldn't handle the ball on the break.
Right. Possibly there. You're right. Meeks on the other end, and that could be a 3-for-2 or 5-point swing after the foul committed by Plumlee. Jefferson, I beg your pardon.
Kennedy Meeks was a little bit slow getting back on defense on that fast break, but as soon as they got the ball, then he was in great position on the offensive end. if you're North Carolina, you just got to keep working. You just got to keep playing. Meeks, good numbers against the Panthers.
Justin.
28-22, North Carolina mounting a mini comeback. But they still have to solve these open looks that Cook has been getting. How about that? A nice steal. Berry, that helps. Then Jefferson got it. Out of the scrum. Jackson feeds. Britt back to Jackson. Offensive foul on Britt. Player control as Tyus Jones took the charge from Nate Britt.
Louisville announced that Chris Jones was suspended, and so it's going to be tough for the Cardinals to play without him.
Miami had to have that win against Virginia Tech. Absolute must for Jimmy Larranaga's team trying to get off the bubble. Jefferson with a jump hook. Okafor tried to tip it through, but did tip it alive. We got a recycle.
See, you've got to block Okafor out right there. You should not be looking at trying to help out. If Okafor doesn't have the ball, just keep him away from the ball and the basket.
Oh, what a cut. And an even better find by Jones. Jefferson's got six.
All because Kennedy Meeks did not block out Jahlil Okafor. I mean, it's not like he's got the element of surprise. Everybody knows all about him.
Bryce Johnson too strong. Taken down by Jones. Okafor has that pass stolen on the bounce pass entry. Fifth turnover committed by Duke. Berry with a jump stop bunny. Johnson with a follow. 30-24. Hey, considering the problems North Carolina had defensively early, got to feel good about being down only six with over eight to play in the half.
Tim, they're doing exactly what we said they needed to do. They're hanging in the game. They were in danger of being blown out, and for the moment they have sort of had that danger pass.
Yeah, the support role, the backup guards have performed well. Here's Okafor.
Wow.
That's strong against Meeks.
Now, you don't help out against him, I think, when he's down in the middle. But when he's dribbling the ball to the basket, good heavens, somebody's got to come try to take it away.
Johnson goes reversal and knocks it down. And these guards that have come in, Joel Berry's been a factor, no question. They've gotten what they needed from the backups in the backcourt as Grayson Allen is fouled, taking it to the rack. To Mike Krzyzewski with one of the one-and-dones that he's had, Austin Rivers in that case. May have a few more like that. His four freshmen have just been impeccable. We talked to him before the game, and he's clearly excited about the way they've been playing. Closed captioning for our ACC basketball is brought to you by Bojangles Famous Chicken and Biscuits. It's bow time. I think maybe the point he was trying to make, Dan, is nationally, maybe these freshmen aren't getting the kind of love that maybe some other freshmen may be getting. Just a thought. There's some other freshmen wearing blue.
He would never try to put that thought into your head.
I'm okay with it. I think he's got a point.
Now, I missed it, but that was Marcus Page's first field goal attempt of the game.
And Plumlee, future lieutenant, comes down with a rebound for Duke. Just into the game, number 40 in white.
I think that's a mistake by North Carolina to launch those threes. They've made 10 of their previous 12 field goal attempts, taking the ball to the basket. That's what they need to continue to do.
Yeah, Berry especially. He and Britt were both very effective, and they needed to be, with Page saddled with the early foul difficulty and out of the game. So far, an 0-for for him as he comes back onto the deck.
Oh, don't leave him.
He did, and that's what happens. Tyus Jones has five. Well, that's just almost beyond comprehension. Good high-low game. Meeks, yes, and a foul. Jefferson will pick it up. His second.
Now, Tim, one of the interesting things is you have to know what's going on. Here's Tyus Jones right there. He's going to come over to here and watch what happens. And when he comes off the screen, Kennedy Meeks jumps out. Now, Meeks leaves him, and he leaves a 42% free throw shooter in ACC play. Leaves him all alone. My heavens.
You know, I realize you're supposed
to. He won't get an easier one in practice.
I mean, I know you're supposed to show against the ball screen, but that was just a token show, if you will. I mean,
He expected his teammate to come back and help him, and so that was not very good communication
right
there.
No, not at all.
but you cannot leave one of Duke's three-point shooters all alone.
That was amazing. Meeks sits down. He has played very well and emerged and become a far better offensive player this season. Dropped a lot of weight. The former McDonald's All-American who earned all freshman honors a season ago. There's the dump down to Okafor. Quickly doubled. Help from Hicks to James. And there's an alley-oop to Jefferson. And the push will go against Isaiah Hicks. The last three champions have been veteran teams that you may have forgotten. I bet if you polled most fans around, even the Carolinas, and you should name the last three championship teams of the tournament, they couldn't do it.
Well, I think the Carolinas, they're blocking that out because they've been Florida State, Miami, and Virginia.
And what do they all have in common? Think about it.
They have five guys on the team?
No. They were senior-laden teams. They were veteran basketball teams, all of them. And it's something you don't see a lot of at this level, and especially at North Carolina and Duke. You're having more one-and-dones. You don't have the luxury of holding on to players as long as some of those other schools do. Hicks picks up that foul, his second.
Ray Williams has to be a little bit concerned right now. His guys battled their way back in by being patient, by attacking inside. But that last time, they almost turned it over, and as a result, they got going really, really fast again and took some tough shots. And when you take a tough shot against this Duke team, generally you're going to pay for it.
Jefferson at the free throw line. Other than Page being scoreless and with those early fouls, does anything just jump out at you statistically about what we've seen transpire here in the first 13-plus minutes?
I'm not sure that anything has jumped out at me statistically, Tim, but this is my first opportunity to see Jahlil Okafor in person.
Oh.
He is a whole lot better in person than he is on tape, and he is awfully good on tape.
Yeah, I certainly have had that chance to see him a time or two this season, and even in the Wake Forest game, which was probably his poorest offensive game, he just changes the way the game is played. Anybody that's playing against Duke has to account for Okafor first, which automatically takes you a little bit out of what you might normally do.
And in trying to account for Okafor, you have a guy like Emile Jefferson has the opportunity to score 7 points in this half. And that's more points than Okafor has.
Out of that scrum. Out of bounds. North Carolina will have it with 26 on the clock. Barry leaves. Britt comes back onto the floor. Jefferson checks out of the game as well for Duke. Winslow back out there with Cook, Okafor, Matt Jones.
North Carolina hadn't gotten any help from Tokido yet, and they're going to need some of that.
And Tyus Jones is out there too. Page still scoreless. Okafor clears. Winslow's pass was a lazy one. It's picked off. Leads to an outlet. Tokido gets it done. His first bucket. You asked for him to respond, and he did.
That's a good defensive sequence for North Carolina right there. That's really the best they've done trying to double-team Okafor and then recover it.
Off the curl. Cook. Not there.
That's good defense by Britt. Now North Carolina pushing the ball.
Tokido the rebound, Page the three. Timeout, Coach K. And the North Carolina bench erupts. You asked for Tokido. Well, turn the page, and Tokido is alive again.
Well, Tokido is a guy, of course, with tremendous athletic skills, and this is just an opportunity for North Carolina. They steal the ball and get it ahead to Tokido, and everybody knows he can dunk. That is a great catch. And then Tokido gets an offensive rebound, and that's an area where he can really help, particularly when he kicks it back out to a wide-open Marcus Page.
So an 8-1 run for the Tar Heels brings them back to within four.
And, Tim, how have they done it? They've gotten stops on the defensive end and have been able to get out and run in transition. What you have to do against this Duke team, they're going to run at you. They're going to score points. You have got to score some points on your end of the court.
And Roy said it was, Roy Williams told us before the game, it sounds maybe basic, almost, like a Captain Obvious, but they're going to score. You've got to score with them. Those were his direct quotes. And we've got a push on the follow of his own shot by Tyus Jones. That one will go against Joel James, his second.
That's a really tough play. I thought North Carolina did a nice job forcing Jones into a very difficult shot, but because Jones was able to penetrate the lane, he created an opportunity for an offensive rebound.
Not many better at the line than this young man.
Well, and if there's anybody even close to him, it's his backcourt mate Cook. Between right. The two of them in ACC play, each of them in conference play shoots better than 90% from the line.
Yeah, Quinn overall is 91% for the season. 65 free throws. Jones nails both of those. He's got 7, and the lead is 6.
Well, at least during this recent Duke winning streak, not overall in conference play, but as Duke has played better, these guys have really turned it up shooting the free throws.
Tokoto off the bounce. James, he's been strong on the offensive glass. He's using that left arm. Nice little look-see to the Duke bench afterwards, too, as though that may not have been in the scouting report.
He's got 6 points off the bench. In fact, the North Carolina bench has been outstanding.
Look at that, 14-2. Job done off of the Carolina Pine. Okafor, too strong, Plumlee, out to Cook for 3. Jones with the follow, and Okafor, is that Okafor? No, it's Matt Jones down. No, it's Okafor. Okafor is on the deck. My first inclination was that it was Jahlil, and it is. Went with the turnaround, and this is as silent as you'll ever hear this building. It happened on that play. We'll check on him and be right back. Moments ago, trainers, Coach K all out there, they were able to get Jahlil Okafor up. He was given quite a bit of assistance early. It was interesting that as he continued to walk, he needed less assistance. Here's what happened.
Now, that's something you see in basketball all the time. He just came down on the foot of Joel James and turned his ankle. And this is a guy they can ill afford to lose, obviously. Leads the ACC not only in scoring but in field goal percentage, an outstanding rebounder.
So much of what they do systematically, as you see, Jabari Parker was a one and done with this team a year ago. The man for whom Okafor in many respects replaced. It'll be interesting to see what their offensive approach will be with Jahlil out. An extended period, if in fact that's the case. Jefferson got the rejection. And a foul was spotted. It's a push. It'll go against Kennedy Meeks, his first.
I think Joel Berry put his teammate in a really tough situation right there. He drove the ball into nothing but trouble. You know, it's interesting. When North Carolina has been able to attack, but attack with patience, they have been very successful. And they've gotten in a big hurry. They're in trouble. And you foul one of these backcourt guys for Duke, you're basically giving them 2 points.
Especially when you're in the double bonus already. They've collected 10 team fouls. And Okafor is up walking around. That's one of the reasons why you're hearing the ovation from the crowd. So that's good news. This may be the only time he gets to play in the Battle of the Blues. I'm sure he wants to get back out there. At least in this building, the only time. Britt. That grazed the iron. Taken down off the deck by Matt Jones.
North Carolina has stayed in the man-to-man.
Matt Jones for 3. They'll add him to the 3-ball party, and here comes a swipe off the pressure from Duke. Jefferson gets the pilfer. Cook right where he wants it. They had cut it to four. Duke responds up 13, all with Okafor out. A leaner from toe-to-toe. He gets the roll. 49-38. Four in the game for J.P. Tokoto. Duke is in the midst of another great run. They are 7 of 9, Dan, from downtown. They're getting some really good three-ball looks. North Carolina's defense at the perimeter, not where they need it to be.
This is where North Carolina's had some success. Getting the ball up the court and running. Duke doing a nice job that time, though, getting back on defense. And Johnson's going to pick up a foul for an illegal screen.
The 1998 Player of the Year. You'll have plenty to say, I'm sure. All of that coming up on the Hardys Halftime Report. Scoop to the hoop that does not go. Johnson with a quick release to Nate Britt. End to end. His reversal doesn't go. Johnson's follow won't. Oh, he gets it again. It's very rare. You see a hustle play like that on a 50-50 ball against Duke. A little stick-to-itiveness there by Bryce Johnson. Tough pass to make that time, a little risky. Leads to a tie ball. And the arrow is to Duke. They'll keep it on this end of the floor.
One of the things we talked about for North Carolina was to have some toughness, and they certainly evidenced some toughness right here. Ball rolls right off, and Johnson just goes right after it. Stays with it, picks it up off the floor.
Crowd responds as Okafor returns to the lineup.
Well, fortunately, that was one of those plays that you see very often. You turn your ankle like that in a basketball game. Sometimes the pain is excruciating, but once you walk it off, you're okay. Now, he's going to be sore in the morning.
Oh, yeah. But you've got to know he's thinking what everybody else is thinking. This is likely the only time he gets to play North Carolina in this building. He wants every minute that he can get in this game.
Well, actually, he was probably thinking, boy, my ankle really hurts and I'd like to get back in the game.
Yeah. Well, fans and journalists certainly are apprised of how short his stay is likely to be. And another foul.
That's an illegal screen against Tyus Jones. He never got stopped. You can't just block a guy.
Well, Plumlee checks back in. I think Jahlil thought he was coming in for him, and he told him, no, you're staying in. He came in for Jefferson. Okafor is hobbled. He's clearly favoring that ankle. Last shot coming for North Carolina. Britt. Oh, the follow is a beauty by Tokoto. A human pinball going after the rim in a relentless manner to get his 6th point of the game and some momentum for North Carolina to close this half, Dan.
Well, I think this is a very important sequence here for North Carolina. They battled back from being down 13. And we talked about J.P. Tokoto. One of the ways he can help this team is go to the offensive boards. We've seen that twice today. Once he got a rebound, kicked it out for three. That time he got the dunk. Good response by North Carolina to close the half.
They do it with a 6-0 run, carving that Baker's dozen down to only 7 here at the intermission. Touched on Okafor, and when he makes a bucket, it's memorable. Isn't it?
Well, I think the thing that has bothered the Duke fans is he turned his ankle. Now he's got a blocked shot in the game. He has made 3 field goals, only really attempted 6 field goals, but he has shown the ability to drive the ball to the basket.
That's where he got hurt.
Now this is injury right there. He turned that ankle and it was very painful at the time, but he is able to get back in the game. The official report we have from Duke is that he tweaked his ankle. Easy for the trainer to say, and that he's going to play, and obviously he's out there.
Might be more difficult after the break, having that much time for it to swell. There's Tokoto's first shot, does not go. Winslow with the long rebound. Outlet Tyus Jones. Jefferson missed the layup.
That's great hustle by Tokoto. That
after missing that shot, got down the court and played some defense.
Pocatello takes the skip pass, is rejected. And then they turn it right back over. Here's Page with numbers.
Got to convert this.
5-on-2. Bryce Johnson gets it to go. He has 14 in the game now, and it's 49-44.
Mike Krzyzewski trying to explain that he thought there was a kick ball, either that or he's working on a new dance step over there, and I think that's probably unlikely. There he's got his kick ball. Even though Okafor only attempted 6 shots in the first half, he was the focus of the North Carolina defense. And I think a lot of the openings that were created for his teammates were because North Carolina was trying to double team him, and he did not force it. Made a couple of nice passes.
Winslow to wrap around. Justice Winslow has 8.
That was just very poor defense by J.P. Tokatoe. He's got this reputation as this great defensive player and a very athletic kind of guy, but he just didn't move his feet at all right there. And Winslow went right by him to the basket.
He has those dynamic defensive plays, but it's the consistency on defense that gets away from him from time to time. That's what Roy Williams is always concerned with, a little more consistency.
Jackson hasn't been a factor in the game at all today.
Baseline extended. That one goes crying off the front iron, and Winslow clears again. Outstanding rebounding combo guard. Okafor gets the quick double and is fouled on the reach. It'll go against Bryce Johnson of North Carolina, his 2nd.
Now that's a very, very difficult matchup for North Carolina. Johnson picked up the foul coming over to help, and I think in that situation you simply have to rely on Kennedy Meeks to move his feet and stay in between Okafor and the basket to make Okafor shoot a jump shot.
Now, it's not a bad idea, by the way, to put Okafor at the line. He's 80 of 140 at the stripe coming into tonight, 57%. Rather that than an easy crossover step finger roll lay-in. I mean, you got the fouls to give. One thing North Carolina's got that other teams don't, a bevy of big men. And they may not all be completely healthy, but they've got fouls to give. 0-for-2 at the stripe. And then they give up an offensive rebound. Jefferson with the easy one.
Jefferson is an outstanding offensive rebounder, but that was more a case of Kennedy Meeks just not being able to hang on to the basketball.
Winslow deflects it. Okafor retrieves it. A beautiful pass. And then he missed the shot. Winslow couldn't have been more open. Out of bounds, it belongs to North Carolina.
I think he anticipated getting a lot more pressure than he got because he got none. This is an outstanding pass. He's ready for it. Instead of dunking, he tries to lay it in and misses it.
As we come back live, there's a lay-in by Page.
But Page was also very quiet in the first half. He only attempted 4 shots, only made 1 of those. They need a lot more offense from him. But despite all the things that have gone poorly for North Carolina, they are still in pretty good position right here.
Yeah, you'd give them a puncher's chance, wouldn't you?
Absolutely. Down 7 points, 17 minutes to go.
Meeks. They're using the strength of that upper body going right at the chest of the ailing Okafor.
And Okafor is a guy who cannot afford to be really aggressive on the defensive end anyway. He's just much too important to his team to get in foul trouble.
Yeah, and he is not himself. He is clearly favoring the ankle. He's still worthy of being double-teamed. That leaves Jones open. Can't get it to go. North Carolina should have a much easier time on the glass with Okafor hobbled. Bryce Johnson already has 9 rebounds. Meeks the fall-away, Jay. Oh, the iron kind early here to North Carolina. They're down 3.
And they're going right at Okafor. How about this?
Now, I'm going to tell you, Okafor is not himself. At a certain point, you begin to wonder, how effective he'll really be over the next 16 plus minutes. He's missed a couple of free throws. He just turned it over. He's not himself.
That was actually a really quick move right there. He just dribbled the ball off his foot.
Shows up more on this end of the floor. Injuries always do, don't they? On the defensive end, you notice it more. They tend to hobble a little more on.
Yeah, guys are always more hurt on defense. Always feel a little bit better on offense. Yeah.
See if North Carolina continues to attack him. Hicks over Jefferson. Tokoto with the tip in.
And there is another offensive rebound by Tokoto. He is actually making a significant contribution today. Something that he has not done in the last couple of games.
How energetic number 15 is on this end of the floor off the ball. Runner not there. Jackson with a release. He's got Tokoto with him. North Carolina leads on the reverse hammer slam. First lead of the game. Timeout. Duke. Duke's biggest lead was 13. But they haven't scored a field goal, Dan, since 18:26 remained in the first half.
Well, North Carolina clearly has responded to a couple of Duke runs. Let's see how Duke responds to a North Carolina run.
First and foremost, getting Okafor involved and having a pass. That's a beautiful pass from him. And an offensive foul, player control. North Carolina's Isaiah Hicks in position to collect the charge from Quinn Cook. Attack, attack, attack. That's what North Carolina's doing. It's now 54-53. See the shooting story in the second so far. North Carolina having its way. The freshman can't get it to go, but there's Tokoto again on the glass. Okafor deflected it. Page retrieved it. Jackson rejected by Jefferson and the putback by Meeks.
Hey, that's great hustle by North Carolina. Tim, that's the toughness that we were talking about before the game, and they have shown that tonight.
Tyus Jones not there. Okafor comes down with the offensive board. Missed one from point blank range. Comes down gingerly on that ankle. It's a 12-0 run. Late getting down the floor, Meeks attacks the glass, and there's a foul underneath. Okafor is not himself.
He gets caught underneath the basket here, and with that ankle, he just doesn't have the explosion to get up through the traffic on the inside. Now you can see he's favoring that ankle, very slow getting up the court, and that's why Kennedy Meeks was open under the basket.
Dan, so much of what Duke does from an offensive standpoint this year is through Okafor. Now in the past, without that true low post player, and Mike Krzyzewski's had that kind of team before, he would spread the floor, dribble drive, and then create threes. Is there any chance you think he might go to that if Okafor can't be effective the rest of this half?
Tim, that's obviously an option. I think it's hard to change your style of play in the middle of a game, particularly when you only got 8 scholarship guys to start with.
Well, you see the drought we were talking about. 420 and counting. Good pass out of the double team by Okafor. He can still attract attention and leave an open player. And in that case, he got it to Jefferson, who was fouled.
Well, but the key there that time, Jefferson, rather than stand and watch, he passed the ball to Okafor, and then when his man went to double, he cut to the basket. Duke did a great job in the first half of finding the open areas when Okafor was double-teamed. They have to get back to that.
Again, though, still if you're North Carolina, rather foul Jefferson than give up the easy one. A little over 55% at the stripe. Closed captioning for ACC Basketball brought to you by Bojangles, famous chicken and biscuits. It's bow time.
Now Jefferson, though, now has 11 points in the game. He has made a significant offensive contribution.
And he's going to need to continue to do that, given the circumstances with number 15 in white. Meeks is doubled. Hicks, good, up and under. Rejected by Winslow, but count the basket. They're going to say the ball was on a downward flight.
But certainly on a downward flight after Winslow hit it. Winslow comes from behind, and that ball,
I like the call.
It's coming down. But watch Winslow. One big step and swat. There are not too many guys in this league who can make a play like that.
Yeah, the freshman from Houston St. John's is pretty explosive. And Kennedy Meeks is checked out. And boy, did he play well while he was in there. Joel James equally effective off of the North Carolina bench, now checking Okafor. Good pass again. Jefferson, yes, and a foul.
Jefferson does such a nice job taking advantage of the attention that's paid to Okafor. And this is just, Hicks goes to double team. Okafor finds the open man. Jefferson catches the ball going to the basket. That's just a really good play. If you're Hicks, you've got to be much more aggressive with that double team, or you fake at him and get back to your man. Hicks was in no man's land there, and Jefferson made him pay for it.
Dan, given Okafor's situation, are you a little surprised that they continue to double him on the defensive end, North Carolina? I'd like to see if he's got all of his moves that are in his repertoire. I'd like to see if he's got them offensively.
Now, I think that it would be a good idea to make him prove he can play one-on-one in the post.
Yeah.
But if you're going to double team him, you have to be better than that. Hicks like went halfway, and he can't go halfway.
When you double Okafor, you're clearly leaving 5-on-4. Here's Page with a little teardrop that goes off the back iron. James, the offensive rebound. Okafor cannot get up even on the defensive glass. North Carolina's getting a lot of offensive rebounds. More right here.
Boy, that was toe-to-toe again, very nearly tipped that ball in.
Very absolutely out-rebounding Duke in large measure because Okafor just doesn't have that lift. 59-57. Winslow, toe-to-toe takes it down. Britt hits the deck underneath. Page runs the show.
Duke has stayed in that man-to-man all night long.
Shot clock under 10. Britt. Hicks turns down the key. Can't get it to fall, and Okafor clears. 7 rebounds for the big fella. Britt, Berry, and Johnson will come in on the next dead ball for North Carolina. Okafor lost it.
That's good defense by James.
Toe-to-toe to the trailer, Hicks.
Now that was a really good play by toe-to-toe. And normally you'd expect him to try to dunk that basketball, and had he done that, he'd have picked up an offensive foul. But he got himself stopped and made a very nice play. And North Carolina, they've been able to force turnovers and get out and run as a result.
Outscored them 20-10 in that category. A three ball for Cook. 61-60. Quinn's got 18 on the night.
All of them coming on three-point shots, and that is a tremendous weapon for the Duke Blue Devils. Just because we haven't seen it in a little while doesn't mean it's gone away.
Hicks, toe-to-toe, Britt, Page, and James, the five on the floor for North Carolina. Britt off the bounce, not there. Cook comes down with a rebound. It's 1-on-2. He's going to challenge. And on the tap out, North Carolina will have a break. But Page brings it back out.
You just feel the intensity in this building ratcheting up each time the clock ticks.
Page goes crossover. With a floater, won't go. Okafor claims his 8th rebound of the night.
That was a really good defensive job by Jefferson to move his feet and force Page to shoot it over top.
Field goal shooting story of the second half. Okafor finally gets That's one to go. That will energize the building. Jahlil Okafor at the stripe, looking to extend the lead to two. His first bucket since 7:26 remained in the first half. Could be an old-fashioned three-point play. Nope. 0 for his last three at the free throw line.
It's really the first time, though, Tim, he's been able to catch the ball that close to the basket.
Out of the timeout, North Carolina has Joel Berry back in the game. Got a foul. Avalon is giving you a chance to pick this year's All-ACC first and second teams. Log on to the acc.com/fanvote. Pick your all-star lineup. Cast your vote on the acc.com/fanvote today. Okafor did get that foul. Brent can't connect.
And that's part of the problem for North Carolina. They've only made one three-point field goal in the game today. Duke, on the other hand, 8 of 11 shooting threes. That's 72%. Tim, the Blue Devils only shooting 44% inside the arc.
And they settled in that sequence. Really did. Winslow trying to get past Johnson. Bryce Johnson now, who's been very effective in this game, now has three.
That is a very difficult matchup for Johnson, trying to guard Winslow. Winslow has the quickness that he can go right by him, and he showed you right there. Johnson basically stumbling to try to catch up, committing that foul.
Cook. Well, that's too easy. That's right where he wants to get the ball. Outlet from Meeks to Tokoto. He'll challenge the 10, and he's going to be fouled. Winslow moving in that time. Picks up his third.
But sometimes you just shake your head at what Kennedy Meeks can do with an outlet pass. My goodness.
Tokoto. Has had his moments tonight. He's going to need to have more if North Carolina is to pull this out. The conventional wisdom was that this Duke team was just playing too well for North Carolina, particularly given all they've been through emotionally, the program the past week, and being blown out at Pitt the way they were. That day against Pitt, I mean, Pittsburgh would have beaten a lot of teams, but North Carolina really struggled on the defensive end. And I think that stayed with a number of pundits coming into tonight's game. This is different. This is the Battle of the Blues. It cures a lot of ills in this game.
Now Bryce Johnson did a really nice job that time cutting off the baseline. I think if Winslow's going to drive on him, he's got to be more aggressive.
Page got a hand on that. Was deflected. I think we're going to have a conversation, maybe an overrule coming here. And they do award the ball to North Carolina. That's the 12th turnover committed by Duke.
North Carolina's been able to produce some points after those Duke turnovers.
Really,
let's see
have.
If the Tar Heels can produce some more.
One of the real pluses in this game for them. 20 points off turnovers. Britt not there. Again, settling, Dan.
Right now, that wasn't Britt. That was
Barry
shooting the ball. And Roy Williams is saying, guys, what are we doing?
Yeah.
They have been dominant on the inside. And, if you're going to shoot that with 1 second left on the shot clock because you're desperate, that's one thing.
That was
get the ball inside.
Now, that was way too early in the clock.
Well, North Carolina's 1 for 9 shooting threes now. Even if you're open, throw the ball inside.
Johnson.
There you go.
Whether it's Britt or Berry, settling on a three ball is not the way to go. Matt Jones. Well, Johnson secured his 7th double-double of the season. 16-10 for him. Great hustle by Okafor. It's on the deck. So we have a tie ball and the arrow going the other way. It'll belong to Duke.
Now Okafor does a really nice job getting around Kennedy Meeks here. Meeks doesn't really hold him off effectively. Meeks is off balance and Okafor takes advantage. That is a really nice play.
What was score in the other game in the ACC taking place. Believe it or not, there is one. 53-50. Florida State with five and change remaining. Others along our ACC network will see
that Jim, game. Jim Christian of Boston College must be wondering how many close games you can lose in that season.
Wave it off. Foul was prior to the shot on the drive. Lot of emotion. Two national championships there, four there. Pair of Hall of Famers. We urge you to join the ACC.com. Jeff, Antoine, and our friend Seth Davis, whom I've worked with for many years, all coming up on the ACC.com immediately after our game. Plenty for them to talk about, no doubt about that. Okafor. Tough pass for Jefferson to corral. Out of bounds off him, and North Carolina gets it back. Okafor's idea was solid, but the trajectory of the pass a little low.
He threw it to the wrong place. Jefferson was covered in there. Okafor, for the most part, has done a nice job finding the open man. He didn't do it that time.
22 points off those turnovers. Let's see if they can cash in here. There's Meeks. Passed Okafor, and he'll pick up the foul. Nope, they're going to say the bucket counted. Counted. Got it on the way down. No foul called.
I may have hit that ball after it touched the backboard.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
No help in the back. Okafor has to come and get it, and that's what happened. The ball was above the rim. It had hit the backboard, and under the rule, once that occurs, you can't touch it.
The one thing from our perch that we can see pretty nicely is the rim and whether the ball is on a downward flight or upward flight. We are not courtside. We are well up in the top of Cameron Indoor Stadium. And a nice move by Jackson that time.
And that may be Jackson's first basket of the game.
Yeah, 68-62. It's North Carolina's largest lead of the night.
It's been 3 minutes since the Blue Devils have scored a field goal. Well, Meeks and Okafor really banging on one another inside.
Shot clock under 10. Leaner won't go. Quickly, Meeks gets up without outlet. You touched on it, Dan. This break was fast. Hicks, yes, and a foul. He actually stared that one away from Jackson. Yeah, he might have had the easier shot.
Yeah, he actually intercepted the pass. You talk about a fast break. That's really fast when you got one of your players stealing it from another one. But again, the outlet pass is the key. You're right. That ball was right to Jackson.
Oh, man.
Hicks not only got the ball from him, he knocked him down.
I don't think they would have gotten the and one if Jackson had gotten it. They got the and one because Hicks stole it away from Jackson.
And now they get an offensive rebound. Up and over Okafor, whose lift has been affected from a hobbled ankle in the first half. He's not been himself, but he's been out there, and he's been effective in terms of attracting attention. But little else. Good pass up and under. Barry is rejected.
Well, Okafor may not be himself, Tim, but he is much better than most guys could be out there.
No doubt about it. But North Carolina's been much more effective going to the glass and attacking the rim because of his not being able to be as effective. Jackson can't get that one to go.
Jackson really forced that one. That's when you kick it back out. Just because you have the ball close to the basket doesn't necessarily mean you have to shoot it.
Guys like Jones and Cook and Winslow are going to have to make differences here. Tyus nails that one. He's got 11. 70-65. The big fella can't bring what he normally would. And that means the guards have got to be stellar for Duke. Three ball story. All with the Blue Devils. Without it, this would be a blowout for Carolina. There's a three. Answered from deep. Barry coming off that groin injury and playing very well, as he did against Pitt the other day. The lead has catapulted to 8 for North Carolina. Cook in traffic. Isaiah Hicks clears. North Carolina loses that one. Winslow's on the other end. End to end. That's a block.
you know, what I'm seeing here is, we've mentioned before, Duke only has 8 scholarship players, and I'm actually seeing some fatigue on the part of the Duke Blue Devils. That time the fast break went up the court, and Emil Jefferson just simply stood underneath the basket here. He didn't even try to get down the court.
Berry got the foul, and Winslow at the free throw line. Jefferson takes a seat. Mike Krzyzewski understanding when he sees hands on hips. Some substitutions are needed. North Carolina does the same with Jackson and Isaiah Hicks checking out of the game. Got to be ready for the stretch run. For those of you that just joined us, Duke came out sizzling. North Carolina answered. Okafor got hurt. He hasn't been the same since. North Carolina has really taken advantage of Duke turnovers. They've turned them into points. And they have this lead as a result. On the overplay, we've got an injured official hitting the deck there. They'll check on...
It's Pat Driscoll.
That is Pat Driscoll that's being helped up. Looks to be okay. Roger Ayers over there to check on him.
Well, J.P. Tokido has played very, very well tonight, but that time he made a very risky pass. North Carolina very fortunate to keep the ball. That's been a problem for Tokido in recent games, is turnovers. Not tonight, though.
Britt, a leaner, yes, and a foul. Tyus Jones picks it up.
That was an extremely difficult shot. Britt does a nice job cutting into the lane, but he goes into traffic there. Okafor doesn't really come over and try to help. That's a good play. Really, really tough shot.
Jeff Caper, part of this rivalry as a player, hit a half quarter once, an overtime game. That ball's tapped out.
Well, it's a rebound. You're allowed to pick it up. Nobody has possession on a rebound.
North Carolina retains it. Jeff did that in the 1995 game. There you see the offensive glass. And again, I think that's impacted really by Okafor's injury. That's just too easy. That's a tired Duke team that you commented on, Dan, no doubt about it. And I think probably the guy lumbering most is Okafor. In traffic, Winslow. Not there.
Dan, Duke has really taken tough shots. That's not what we saw in the first half. Great ball movement even after dribble penetration. Now they're making dribble penetration and just throwing it up.
This run now 16-5 and continuing. Johnson, the turnaround won't go. Okafor with those big mitts snares it. Who among these guards will be the difference maker? Could it be him? Could it be Winslow? Timeout. Duke with 3:02 remaining. Right now, North Carolina has control of this game. Tokido likes the matchup and challenges Jones and connects.
You know, when Tokido can get the ball 10 to 12 feet from the basket and use that leaping ability to rise up above the defense, he can be very effective. He has been outstanding tonight. And mainly he's been outstanding by not trying to do too much.
There it is. Little give and go between Okafor and Winslow. Old school, but the finisher is Winslow. Okafor can facilitate.
Well, now Duke needs stops. Obviously, you're not going to come back in the game if you just trade baskets, so they've got to get a couple of stops. Roy Williams wants him to spread the court. Give Marcus Page some room.
Goes to the left hand. Great touch. He did everything but get it to go. But quality move with no production. Winslow, ball fake and a drive. He'll get to the line. Duke's problems at the free throw line continue. 10 out of 17 prior to that miss, so now 10 out of 18 with Winslow at the line.
late in the game, as we mentioned earlier, probably not a bad idea if the ball gets to Okafor or to Winslow. Found him. Offensive rebound for Duke. A wide open three for Jones. Loose ball, Winslow again has it. Jones drives and gets it done. Off the window. Timeout, Blue Devils.
Boy, North Carolina, they're really upset with themselves. They just simply could not secure that rebound. Bryce Johnson, who has 16 points and 11 rebounds, just can't corral the thing, and the result is finally Tyus Jones takes the ball to the basket and scores an important 2 points for the Duke Blue Devils.
90%, 46 to 51. Coming into tonight's game. And as we say that, how about Tokoto tapping it out? But Tyus Jones collects it. He goes the distance and he's fouled by Barry.
You know, that was such, you mentioned he's a 90% free throw shooter, but that was such a bad miss that it allowed Duke to really get out and go.
You know, Tokoto actually helped Duke there by slapping it out. Although you figure it's a heads up play, thinking one of your guys might get it. These are huge free throws, and think about the swing of the missed free throw by a 90% free throw shooter leading to a run out, and two free throws now coming for Tyus Jones. 87% at the line on the year. And that could get them to within a possession in a 3-point game. And you can crank up the amp meter in this building after this free throw goes through.
North Carolina going with three guards along with Johnson and Meeks.
Here we go.
And Duke is in a situation they don't have to foul. You do have to play tough defense. North Carolina has been much more successful in transition than they have been in the half court sets.
And a foul against Duke. Blue Devil fans don't like it, but Bryce Johnson again relentlessly attacking the 10, and Winslow has four.
That was great movement of both the ball and players by North Carolina.
Yep, got him with the arm. Crowd may not like it. It was a foul.
And Johnson has done really a nice job getting the ball inside, and now they're trying to decide who the foul is on. And Winslow's upset.
He should, well.
They're saying that that's five fouls on Winslow. That's this.
It's a one possession game.
And he's only a 63% free throw shooter.
Yeah. Start with. I mean, this is advantage Duke. That's a big free throw for Johnson.
Well, in a game like this, you need your guys to make plays, and Johnson just did, making that free throw.
Three out of three tonight. It's what have you done for me lately? And tonight he's been perfect at the stripe. Those were big. And you, really, you got to give that kid a lot of credit. Already has a double-double secure. But.
And he comes out of the game on defense, and Tokido's back in. You don't need the three.
A leaner by Jones. Yes, and a foul.
But you'll take it that way.
We set the guards. Mike Krzyzewski's guards would have to be the difference maker. Here he goes against Barry. Right to the chest.
Well, he just outquicked Barry. Barry not able to move his feet and get in front.
Jones has 17.
He's got 17. Cook has 18.
Okafor has been reduced to facilitator in this game. If Duke pulls this out, given everything that's come their way and the injury to Okafor, they'll feel like they stole one, because North Carolina has owned this game in the second half. Quick foul given up by Matt Jones.
And they're going to send Bryce Johnson back to the free throw line.
I mean, think about it. From the end of the first half, that last bucket that was made that cut it to five, to the early moments of the second half, North Carolina's controlled the tempo and pace of play the entire second half. Doesn't get that one. Out of bounds to Duke. .6 seconds the differential, shot clock and game clock all on the line. Number four Duke with possession. Jones tied at 81. He's got 20. Timeout, North Carolina. So here we go. Page, the number one answer from deep. He will trigger the inbound.
And if you're the Blue Devils, you'd like to keep the ball out of the hands of Marcus Page if you can.
Britt runs the show. Cook is checking Page. He got the screen. There's the opportunity missed. Loose ball on the deck. Time winding down. We're headed to overtime. Gets the tap, but Jones lost the ball. Tokoto retrieves it, and Page finds Jackson on the loose. Tokoto. Johnson taps it out, a recycle. Working on Okafor. Oh, Kennedy Meeks. He's been tough, and Okafor that time challenged him.
Meeks has 18 in the game.
Winslow's bumped.
That's it for Johnson.
That's a big loss now for North Carolina. Number five on Bryce Johnson. So he becomes the first player eliminated due to foul difficulty. Isaiah Hicks will check in for him. 18 points and 12 rebounds. Quite a night.
And the majority of his fouls have come trying to defend Justice Winslow driving to the basket. That is a very difficult matchup for Bryce Johnson. But his 18 points and 12 rebounds have to go to the bench.
Well, not a lot was written about it or really broadcasted throughout the nation earlier in the year about Winslow's injury, the shoulder. But he really played in some pain earlier in the year. And he's rounded into shape at about the time Duke caught fire after the second half of that Louisville game. And they responded. Okafor had it and then lost it.
Well, look, he just threw guys out of the way to get the rebound.
He's upset with himself. Opportunity missed. Youngster has played on an ankle and a half here in the second half. There's a steal. Hands of Velcro by Matt Jones.
Well, Hicks just didn't want to have the basketball. He was looking to get rid of it. Needed to be more patient than that.
Working on Jackson. With outstanding freshman there. Tough take defensively against the smaller player for Justin Jackson. Okafor's got it far from the basket. Working on Meeks. Strong move. Yes, and a foul.
Boy, Meeks did a pretty nice job keeping him, making him catch the ball away from the basket. And Okafor just dominated him with the dribble. And Okafor has done such a nice job finding the open man that they don't go and double him that time. And Okafor makes him pay for it.
Dan, it took an overtime, but he just tied Tyler Hansbrough and Stephon Marbury for ACC freshman record for consecutive double-figure games. He got to 10 points. He becomes the third man to do that in his freshman season, so had to work hard to get it. Needed an extra session tonight. Cannot convert at the line, though. Those problems continue. 84-83 Duke.
Justin Jackson for three. And a push off against Kennedy Meeks. That's his fourth.
Justin Jackson with the wide open look from beyond the three-point arc. And he has really struggled today,
Jackson. And he struggled all season. You know, he's such a great player, and Roy Williams wants to, he's still been green-lighted. He knows at some point, I mean, he came in a celebrated player known for his marksmanship from downtown.
But only shooting 21% on the year from three.
And when you think about that, to only be shooting that percentage and yet throwing up that many. If you look at the numbers on Okafor, Ofer at the free throw line. Foul difficulty, you see Johnson out, Barry and Meeks each with four. And Winslow has four for Duke. He's the only Blue Devil in peril. Oh for six at the stripe for Okafor. Tokoto, great look inside, and Isaiah Hicks knew right where to go with it. Inside the cylinder, and it's 85-84. Winslow in traffic.
That was good defense by Hicks. Really moved his feet effectively.
Okafor attacks. Uses the banking board and collects a deuce. It's 87-84. 15 for Okafor. Jones goes crossover. Uses the glass. Return to sender. North Carolina by one.
Jones has scored 14 points in the second half.
Picked it up a little, didn't he?
Yeah, most of them on the attacking the basket.
Page caught in midair and lost it. On the other end, Cook. High arching off the window. That's killing me softly off the pane. He Roberta flapped that one in. Cook reaches in against Hicks, picks up the foul. Feeling a little adrenaline from that last shot. What a thing of beauty this is, Dan.
Well, there's tremendous defensive pressure, but he is able somehow to get that up over two guys. What a shot.
That's just unreal, because you've got to take a little bit off that, knowing that the shot could be blocked and you arch it higher off the window than normal.
There's a lane violation. Matt Jones stepped in.
Uh-oh. That hurts the Duke plate. That ball was halfway down the cylinder and out. So an extra one will come.
Matt Jones very clearly stepped in before Hicks released the ball. Hicks only a 62% free throw shooter.
Sophomore from Oxford, North Carolina gets that one to go. 10 in double figures, 5 for both teams tonight. And you see the free throw shooting story. Both teams have struggled, really. Barry will check into the game, replacing Hicks. Three ties and 7 lead changes tonight. Matt Jones giving it up to Tyus Jones. Winslow, Okafor, and Cook. The 5 on the floor for Duke. No double until very late. He knew what to do with it. 12 in the game for Okafor, and he's not at 100%. But like you said, Dan, his 85 to 90 is better than most.
Well, this is just outstanding. You give a guy with his ability that much time,
to dribble the basketball unmolested. He is going to get close, and he's going to score.
Boy, there's a lot of tired guys out there. Kennedy Meeks trying to catch his breath before he throws the ball inbounds. Remember, Brice Johnson has fouled out.
Tokoto on a pop-out has Matt Jones with him. Hicks is on the floor, along with Britt, Meeks, Hicks, and Page.
They tried to use Hicks to attack Winslow.
Britt navigates. Oh, the wraparound won't go. Tipped out, taken away by Jones. Tyus Jones has it. Tyus has got it with 1:05 remaining.
That was a close shot, but it was not an easy shot. Nice job by Winslow to contest in there. North Carolina looking for the big stop. Duke was able to get a couple down the stretch in regulation. Can North Carolina get one here?
All the way shot and an offensive rebound by Matt Jones. Shot clock differential is about 3.5. That's all. They do foul.
And Roy Williams is disgusted. He did not want them to foul Cook or Jones, and they got Cook. He just shook his head out there.
Not the guy you want to foul, that's for sure. But you had to figure he wanted to extend the game to some extent, because the shot clock differential was going to be at about 3, 3.5, and that was it. Cook, 90% at the free throw line on the year, but his first at the stripe tonight. Oh, the iron really kind. Either way, it's still a one possession game. Two-point game, and that changes things for Roy Williams' team.
But they still, they've got to go. They cannot be hanging on to the basketball. They've got to take the first good shot they can get.
Roy off the ball. Page really being dogged by Cook. Roy felt there should have been a foul. Quick double. Hicks has it.
You got to look at the basket.
Tokoto does. Not there. Rebound Cook and a quick foul by Britt. Roy Williams was beside himself with Page off the ball being dogged by Cook prior to this shot.
Well, that was a situation where Hicks had the ball basically at the free throw line and didn't even look at the basket. Instead, kicked it out to Tokoto. And you can't fault Tokoto. I mean, that way he was open and the clock was running down. He had to take that shot.
Now they're going to have to add time again. Now that's what Roy Williams is talking about there. That's why the officials are at the clock. Everybody on the floor knew Page was the guy Roy Williams wanted to have it. Duke certainly did. Cook had him wrapped up pretty good. Roy was begging for a call and he didn't get it. Take a look at the last 14 seconds.
There's Hicks with the ball. He takes one dribble. He's got a 5-foot shot. Instead, he pitches it back out. And Tokoto, who is not a jump shooter, he's a driver, he's a dunker, he's an offensive rebounder, but he's not a jump shooter, forced to take that shot, and it doesn't go down.
So now, again, your 90% free throw shooter, who did only go 1-for-2 last time, is back at the line, and he can put it away right here with both. It's never easy, is it? It's never easy, is it? Not in this rivalry. North Carolina has a shot to tie it, but it'll take a 3. Oh boy, they got it to half court very quickly and saved those timeouts, and you can utilize them to draw up something, Dan, with 4.7 remaining.
Okafor playing the ball out of bounds. Meeks, of course, has the ability to really throw the ball a long way.
They need help. Grits got it, quickly fouled by Matt Jones. So the situation you find yourself in as Jones commits his third. Here's a free throw. And a miss. You have to make the first.
But you have to make the first before you have any options at all.
Right, got to make the first one. This is the all-important one right here. It's 2 out of 4 on the night.
Okay, now, Tim, most guys try to shoot the ball and miss it here around the rim. But why do that? Why not shoot the ball and miss it so it either goes here or here? That way your guys can run and get it, and they'll be open because all the defensive guys are going to the basket.
A lot of times you like to see, and I know, remember in the Final Four, Aaron Kraft of Ohio State tried it. It did not work out because there was a lane interference, but the quick shot that's hard off the rim, and like a, you get a boomerang effect, and sometimes the players don't expect that, as opposed to going with the high arching shot normally is supposed to come off the high to the left.
The high arching shot, if you're going to shoot the ball in this situation and it's going to come off in the lane area,
yeah,
then that's a disadvantage to the shooting team. But if you're going to shoot the ball so that it comes off hard to one side or the other, you got two guys outside the three-point line. Your opponent only has one. One of your guys can go to the corner and run that down.
Okay.
So I've always thought that, and everybody who's in the lane is stepping in, who's along the lane is stepping into the lane, so they're all going the wrong way. So I've often thought, rather than try to hit it so it bounces up high, shoot it so that it goes off hard to one side or the other and your guys can run it down. See, now you have to stay beyond the three-point line, behind the free throw line extended. But look at where Page is right now.
Yeah.
If you miss the ball over to that the side, the far side of the court, Page can easily get it.
There he is. A great look. Rebound to Duke. It's all over. Blue Devils win in overtime, 92-90.
We are the official home for ACC basketball. For more great content like you've just watched, click one of these boxes. And to make sure you don't miss anything, click subscribe.